In this part, I want to talk about measures of gain. There are many measures of gain. The gain that we want in the end is properly defined as the transducer gain. The transducer gain GT is the power actually delivered to the load divided by the power available from the source. But we can define power in our circuit many ways, and using those different definitions of power, we can define various measures of gain, but we're going to focus on transducer gain for the moment. The power available from our source is the available input signal power, PAI, which may not be the same as the input power actually delivered to the input matching network and the amplifier, because power could be reflected from our input matching network. Another measure of power is the power actually delivered to our active device, and that may not be the same as Pin because we could have a lossy input matching network. At the output of our active device is the available device output signal power, and if our output matching network was ideal and we had optimum matching, all of that power would be delivered to the load. At the output of our matching network is an available output power. Finally, if everything is designed optimally, we will have a load power delivered to our load, which will be the maximum load power that we could have. So transducer gain is the gain that we want in the end. When we're given a design specification of 14 dB, it is the transducer gain that we want at 14 dB. Now, there are many metrics for gain. Two of the useful ones, and the ones that we will focus on here, are the maximum available power gain and the maximum stable gain. First of all, let's look at the maximum available power gain. This is GMA. An important thing here is this ratio of S21 over S12. That is the largest factor here defining our maximum available gain. But then we have this modification factor here with what is called the Rollet stability K factor, because it happens to appear in the expression for stability. The maximum available power gain, GMA, is given by that rather long expression. And if our amplifier is potentially unstable, well, we wanted to find GMA at the edge of stability when K is equal to 1. And that gain is called the maximum stable gain. So it is the transducer gain with optimum M1 and M2. But they may be detuned if we want to make sure our circuit is unconditionally stable. And our maximum stable gain is S21 over S12. Now, we can achieve any gain possible if we used feedback. But without feedback, these metrics give us a very good idea of how we can go about doing design. Design using feedback is a little bit more complex. Sometimes it must be used, especially to make sure we have flat gain across the bandwidth. But with this particular transistor, we can achieve our specifications without using feedback. Now let's consider the particular properties of our transistor. When we plug in the S parameters for our transistor, we find that GMA is undefined from 8 to 12 GHz because our amplifier is not unconditionally stable. Therefore, we need to use the maximum stable gain. And calculating that out, at 8 GHz, the maximum stable gain is 16.4 dB. At 10 GHz, it's 15.8 dB. At 12 GHz, it's 14.8 dB. Just as we expected, the gain does fall off with frequency. Our target transducer gain is 14 dB. And we clearly have a maximum stable gain that is greater than that at 8 GHz, but of course the transistor is going to have a tolerance as well. Different transistors from different batches, even though they have the same model name, will have different characteristics. So we probably want to pull down from 14.8 dB. And the way we achieve this, the way we get our gain down to 14 dB, is to detune the matching networks. We do not need maximum power transfer. Now, what is nice about that is that gives us a little bit of design flexibility. It increases our design space because we are yet to consider noise. Considering maximum stable gain, we see that it is possible to design our amplifier. We could get a gain above the maximum stable gain, but design is going to be tricky and we need to be very concerned about stability.